So a bunch of you have asked me in the comments and in DMs, how do I come up with ideas for my Design with Detour prompts and designs like these right here that I share online. In this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how I do it. I'm gonna show you the research that I do, the prompts that I write in ChatGPT and the prompts that ChatGPT gives me, and we're gonna pick the four for today. So it's August 1st, I haven't done it yet. I don't know exactly what I'm gonna do, so this is gonna be a fun one. You're gonna be able to come along and find out exactly what I do every day for these Design with Detours. So the first thing we're gonna do, step one, is to use the Design with Detour prompt list or topic list. That's this one right here. And because it's a new month, it's August, this is the one that we're gonna use, and the topic is volleyball. So step two is, what I like to do is to do some research, because I sell on Redbubble merch by Amazon or Amazon merch on demand and TeePublic, I like to go there and do some research to see what's selling there, as well as just do a Google search. So we're gonna do those four. Let's go to the internet right now and kind of do a research on see what's popular, not to copy, but to see what's out there, and so I can do something different. All right, so here I am on Amazon merch on demand. I have Pretty Merch Pro Plus right here, and I'm on the research tab. And I just typed in volleyball. So let's take a look how many volleyball ones there are. There are a bunch. So let's take a look at some of the graphics that are being used. Of course, a volleyball is a good one. Maybe like some splatter or some USA designs with volleyball. That's interesting. Of course, these two are selling really well right now because of the Olympics. So that makes sense. Some puns here, holy blockamole with a avocado there, that's pretty cool. Ball mom, so we got a mashup of volleyball and football here. So we got volleyball players, that's a good one. Volleyball with words in it. A silhouette, those are always good. We got, looks like a goose, valley goose, I don't understand that one. But a lot of volleyballs, so we can think about different ways to do a volleyball that's not already here. Let's see, volleyball heart, that's really interesting. A spike here, volleyball at the net, and some leopard print volleyball, that's kind of cool. So that's Amazon merch on demand. I also go to TeePublic, I typed in volleyball and sorted it by popular. We have some beach volleyball, that's interesting. We got silhouette, a spiking volleyball here. Again, kind of anime, that's kind of cool. This is kind of neat. This is looks like a pitcher almost, in USA volleyball. So I'm definitely gonna stay away from USA, Team USA and all that stuff. This is also USA volleyball. Malibu, oh, that's interesting. Beach volleyball could be cool. Kind of a half volleyball with some words. That's cool. Oh, this is like a logo there and so on. So a lot of volleyball, skeleton with a volleyball. That might be something interesting that we might think about. This skeleton isn't spiking the ball or anything like that, so it's just standing on the ball. Maybe we have the opportunity to do that with the spiking the ball. Redbubble, same thing. Volleyball here. A lot of different ways to draw the volleyball, right? Like this is the basic way, but then you can color it. USA flag volleyball, that's an interesting one. A turtle in a volleyball, so a lot of different animals with volleyball and so on. So we probably should do one with a volleyball, but like with different things, maybe different colors, patterns, things like that. So let's see, next one here. I'm also on Google. I just did volleyball graphic t-shirts because I think if we did volleyball t-shirts, they might think volleyball team t-shirts. So I did graphic t-shirts because we're really looking for a graphic. So here's a cool one. Wow, I like that splatter paint idea. Spiking again, I think that's a good one. We might have to think about someone spiking the ball. Bump and spike. Oh, happy face volleyball, that's an interesting idea. Cherry volleyball, that's cool. Volleyball with shades, we didn't see that a lot. I think we could work on something like that. So what I would do now is maybe jot down a few ideas or just keep them in my head as we go to ChatGPT. And then just start typing some ideas. I usually don't just do four, I probably do about 10. So hopefully we have time to kind of get those out there. And then you can see I'll pick four from the best ones there. And yeah, let's see what happens. All right, so here I am on chatgpt.com, and I love to use StickerWiz, which is right here, it's on my sidebar. But if you don't have it, What you could do is go to Explore GPTs and then type in Sticker Whiz. You can see it already knows that I'm gonna type it in. Sticker Whiz, like that. And it's gonna be this first one, and you gotta look that it says by ChatGPT. There's a bunch of other copycat ones that call it Sticker Whiz because they know that how everybody's looking for it. Look for the one that's by ChatGPT, and then when you click on it, you can put it on your sidebar as your favorites, and it'll always be there. But yeah, that's what I would do. It used to be featured like the trending or by ChatGPT, but it's not here anymore when you have see more. Yeah, it used to be in the top 12, but it's not anymore. So you have to actually go and look for it. Type in Sticker Whiz, and I love it. I'm not affiliated with it. You can see it was made by ChatGPT, but I like using it, so I'd like to tell people that to use it as well. And you do have to have the plan, the ChatGPT plan. So I'm paying $20 a month for this. And I think that's kind of the only way that you can use these GPTs is if you're paying for the plan. But let's see what it looks like. Sticker Whiz, I'm clicking on it. You can see it right here. And we're just gonna type in one of the prompts. So the first one, I noticed there was some splatter paint ones, which I think is really cool for like this 90s design, and red, white, and blue for USA. So I'm gonna mash those two together. And this is what I got, a colorful splatter paint design volleyball with red, white, and blue. And let's see what happens. All right, well, this is cool. Sometimes it doesn't do this all the time, but sometimes it gives two results and we get to pick one, which one's better. Wow, this one has the stars, and I kind of like this one better though, just because of the layout. This kind of gets weird with the layout. I think this one looks more like a volleyball, although people would know that that's a volleyball. So I'm gonna pick this one and hit a check here, and we're gonna save it. So I'll pick it. I think it's really cool. This is the prompt that ChatGPT wrote. I may use this as one of my top four. I don't know yet, but this definitely one. So, and if you needed to see the other one, it's right under here, one and two, but I'm gonna stick with one. Okay, so let's think of one more, at least three more, right, for my top four. So I remember seeing beach volleyball. I also remember seeing anime. So I'm gonna try and mash those two together. And this is what I wrote. A beach volleyball scene with someone blocking a shot at the net in an anime style. All right, let's see what happens. A lot of times it does really good with anime, so I'm gonna try it. All right, so this is the result. Oh, that's pretty cool. I think we can take that out. I think it would be really neat. I might have to like redraw this volleyball, but that's fine. But I really like this, and it has like the cartoon style and this lines. I like it. I'm gonna save this one. Here is the prompt, and there you go. Die cut sticker, blah, blah, blah. Really easy ChatGPT prompt, and I think it did really well. Okay. So let's save that one. That's number two. All right, so for number three, I want to do a silhouette just because we have an outline one when you have the ball here. So I'm just trying to do something a little bit different. And I remember seeing someone doing a jump serve. I think that's really popular. I want to see what ChatGPT does. A silhouette of a person jump serving a volleyball. So let's see what happens. Hey, that turned out pretty good. I like that. I think I would reverse this ball here because it's a white ball with black lines. I would do a black ball with white lines just to match this right here. But I think that's easy to find. I like it. I think this could do well, especially with like words right here. I think that could do really well. I might save this one. This may not be in my top four just because I can find this anywhere with clip art and stuff, so it's not really that unique. One of the things to do if you're using AI art is to try and do something that you can't find anywhere else, like this one right here. And well, that one could be found in different places, but I really like that. So I'm gonna try and think outside the box now and see what I can come up with. All right, so the next one that I thought about is we saw a skeleton, but he was just standing on the ball and dabbing. So I wanted the skeletons to actually play volleyball. So I wrote this here. A couple of skeletons facing forward, because I want direction, behind a volleyball net. So hopefully they draw the net and then the skeletons are behind the net, blocking a volleyball. Let's see what happens. Well, it didn't do it. They're not blocking the volleyball. They're not even playing. They're just standing in between. So sometimes what I like to do is just ask them to try it again. So I'm gonna say try again. And I think the difference is it didn't know that they wanted both of them on the same team. So we're gonna give them another chance. I said, try again. I want both skeletons on the same team blocking a volleyball from the other team at the net. Let's see if that helps. Nope, it did not help. And sometimes AI just doesn't figure it out. I really wanted them both kind of lifting their hands up and blocking the ball. Maybe that's what I needed to say, is lifting their hands up and blocking the ball. Let's try one more time. Okay, so have them lifting their arms up and blocking the ball. Let's see what happens. Okay, so here it is. It's closer, but for some reason it didn't give two arms. So usually after three attempts of trying something that doesn't work, I go on and do something else. So these aren't gonna make it. It is a great idea though. I think if I had the time and I used some clip art and had skeletons in the back lifting up their arms, could block a volleyball, it could be really cool. Or try a different AI. Sometimes ChatGPT isn't the best for some of these. Or I could draw it, right? Maybe a kawaii version of this I could probably draw. So let's try something else. Okay, I've seen something like this with baseballs before, but I figure when somebody's serving a volleyball, it can go really fast. So in order to do that, I'm thinking flame. So I wrote this, a volleyball serves so fast that it is on fire and has flames behind it. Let's see what happens. Yeah, so that's kind of it. It's kind of a weird way. I wanna see if it does it again. I'm gonna say try again. So I'm just writing nice try again. Let's see what happens. So cool, the only difference is this doesn't look like a volleyball anymore. This one kinda did. And I can get a volleyball and have the flames behind it, but maybe it's one of my top four. I'm not so sure, so let's try something else. Okay, so I was trying to think of different puns, and when you serve a volleyball, I was also thinking a soft serve ice cream. So I wrote this, a soft serve ice cream hitting and serving a volleyball. Let's see what happens. That's kind of cool. It is a soft serve ice cream, but he's not serving the volleyball. He's kind of just holding the volleyball there. Let me try again. All right, so I'm just saying I want him to be hitting the volleyball like a jump serve. So hopefully it understands that. Let's see what happens. So for some reason, I don't like this, and I can't see the eyes, and he's not really serving it. He is jumping. I'm gonna just stick with this one. I mean, it can get the idea across that it's soft serve and volleyball. So let's see, I got one. I don't like these. I got two, possibly three, four. Those could be my top four. I'm gonna try just a little bit more and see what else I can come up with. Okay, another thing that I was thinking of is they're called aces when you hit the serve a volleyball and they can't defend it. So I put this, a cartoon ace of spades hitting a volleyball like a jump serve. So let's see what this comes up with. That's pretty cool. He is kind of serving the volleyball. I like this one better than the soft serve. It's pretty cool. I think we can put something about ace here. That would be really fun. Okay, one more. I gotta do a kawaii version. All right, so I just did a kawaii corgi dressed to play volleyball. Let's see what ChatGPT comes up with. This one's kind of cute. It has a kawaii corgi with the volleyball. It's drawn pretty well. And if I pick this one, I can definitely trace over it like I showed in some of my other videos. I think it's pretty good. I'm gonna keep that one. So let's see. Let's see what the top four should be. I like this one. I like that one. Soft serve, maybe. So there's two. Oh, I haven't showed you what ChatGPT wrote. So here's the one that ChatGPT wrote for this prompt. You can see that right there. So that's one. And what I like to do is I just download it. So if I like this one, I hit the download button, it downloads to my downloads folder. So we'll do that. This one, I really like the ace idea. I might have to put a line right there to fix that. I'm gonna show you what ChatGPT wrote. Not a long prompt there. And I'm gonna download this one. Cool. Let's see. Maybe that soft serve. We definitely want this anime one. So I think we've already seen that. And I'm gonna hit download. All right. I think not that one. That's kind of like everybody else. The skeletons didn't turn out. That didn't turn out. Maybe the soft serve. So I'm gonna do the soft serve and this is the prompt from ChatGPT, and I'm gonna hit download. So now that I have my top four, I'm gonna show you what I do in Affinity Designer and kind of just drag it in. And I already have a template for it, so it's not very hard. to do, but we're gonna just make really quick my ABCD thing that I share on social media, and that will be the end of this video. All right, so here I am in Affinity Designer 2. You can see I'm using the one that I used from July, so I'm just recycling these so it's easy. I have my design with Detour here. I'm gonna change this to say August 1 and then make sure that this is volleyball. I'm just using Helvetica New Regular, and I have Helvetica here as well. And this one just as a call to action, not really a question, so that I'll get more comments, right? So I'm gonna remove these guys here. That was my beer one. And then I'm gonna just drag in the downloads that I got from ChatGPT. So just right in here, we got this guy. And I can put him anywhere, so I'll put him here. I got the volleyball. I think this one's really cool. I might actually use that one. And then I got the ace. That one's really cool too. So you can see I'm trying to use the ones that you can't find in clip art. If you're looking, let's say like on Creative Fabrica or a Creative Market or any place that you get your clip art, I'm trying to do something that when I look for it, there isn't these, right? I don't believe there's a ace of spades hitting a volleyball, right? That's really niche. So I'm gonna come in here and just size this down and size this up. And the thing I like to do is I like to change the same color of my background. So you're gonna see, I'm gonna use the eyedropper tool, drop that in. So now it's kind of the same color. I can also just come in here and use my crop tool and crop it in, because sometimes the edges kind of have this effect on it. So there you go, that's a little bit better. And I'm just gonna make it a little bigger here so it fills the space. Same thing with this one. I'm coming in here and I'm gonna select both of these and move it to the back like this, boom, and change the color here of this one to that. Same thing with this one. Change the color to this gray here using my eyedropper tool. And this one, it's already a square behind it, so I'm just coloring it there. So, and then we can adjust the size to make sure that it fits. Oh, and this should be behind. Let's do that. And make sure the contrast is good. So if this needs to be white because it's dark, I can just come in here and change the color on those. So there you go, some fun ones today. I'm gonna post this on social media, get some feedback, see which one most people like, and then pick that one or pick one that I really like. It sometimes I go off script and actually pick one that I rather do because I like doing kawaii, for example, or I like this one because it's so unique. So hopefully this was a really good tutorial for you, so you can see the whole thing from beginning to picking the topic, from design with Detour to going and doing some research, and then just playing around with different topics and ideas, something different that you haven't seen before, and use that. That's the power of, for me, I think, is the power of AI, is to create something that nobody has thought of, that isn't there on clip art, that you can't find with that. You have to kind of use your imagination and mash up different things. So hopefully this was really helpful for you to be inspired on what to type in the prompts. And I love ChatGPT because how simple the prompts that I use, but then it wrote a more difficult or prompt that really helped it to create something good and unique. And you can see everything isn't always great. Like the first four I didn't use, the skeletons didn't work out. So you just gotta keep massaging it and trying it. And if it doesn't work, try something else. And hopefully after 10 or so tries, you get a good amount of ones that work for you. So thanks again for watching. And if you wanna see another video with ChatGPT on how I take it and make a design, I'll put that one right here. I'm doing this a bunch with Design with Detour and hopefully teaching you a little bit about design and a little bit about AI. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.